3-minute rounds coming up for you in this kickboxing event in Bangkok, Thailand. And the head of Wong Chin Long is up high. He's got to bring that, his hands up as well to stop that quick straight punch with the left jab that Janet Todd has. Really not tucking that chin in at all.
You can see Janet Todd is trying to work in, trying to get nice and tight. She's trying to nullify that reach advantage that Wong Chin Long has. And you can see Janet Todd starting to connect.
Janet will send in lefts and rights. She loves that straight punch, and there seems to be a good opportunity to unleash that one tonight. Just missed with that big straight left. Just moved to the right.
Three seconds.
The referee talking about the clinches there, not lasting any longer than 3 seconds, Mitch. And that's a cultural change that sometimes has to be made.
Yeah, it's tough, you know, especially when Janet Todd's biggest weapon is her clinch. She likes to deliver those knees and elbows inside that clinch. So now she's got to time it. She's got to utilize it very, you know, efficiently.
You can probably see Janet is naturally the bigger of the two women. Her walk-around weight is several kilos heavier.
Yeah, you can see why, you know, Wong Chin Long tried to incorporate strength and conditioning, because just the sheer muscularity of Janet alone is significantly different.
All the time to sheer punches of the ball.
And she also landed a nice, clean, straight 1-2 into that leg kick. You know, I'd like to see Wong Chin Long move a little bit more and get a little bit more out of the pocket, because right now she's just standing toe-to-toe with Todd. And Todd's lighting her up.
Right hand from her over there. I just wonder if she's caused a little bit of damage to Janet's nose. Left hand as well from Long. And they're exchanging here, and Long is not stepping back, is she?
She's right in there. She's right definitely inside the mix. But you know, you can see the way Janet mixes in those attacks. She throws the hands, throws that leg kick, and then she's also throwing the hands as well. There's a significant difference between the amount of strikes that they're throwing between combinations. Beautiful jab to a body kick there by Todd.
Loving a left hook as well. It's a long left hook. It starts out looking like something like a jab, and then she just hooks it at the very last second. It's not a wide arc by any means. Got power, snappiness. Nice left hand there. That was a jab, no question, as Wong was coming in. She attacks the leg as well. Seamless movement from hand to feet. Final 10 seconds of this opening round, and there's been good action here from these two.
You see Wong Chin Long is just eating a lot of these jabs.
Left jab, right kick, left, right, right kick. Janet Todd working very, very hard. Good 3 minutes, that one, from Janet Todd. What do you make of that first round, Mitch?
Yeah, that first round was one-way traffic there for Todd. She was able to utilize that 1-2 with those leg kicks and then go right back into the hands as well. Wong did have some success there with her straight right hand, but also she was able to land a little bit as far as the push kicks are. But she's standing right in the range of Todd. She's got to circle out or at least start moving her head a little bit.
Got a good shot of a clear face, no marks. Whatsoever.
So now she's starting to move around a little bit.
Just putting a nice hand to the right-hand side of her face, though. Well, Janet Todd means business. But so far, even though she's landed some good solid punches, there's no sign that Wong is backing off here or hurt in any significant way.
This is what Todd said she wants to do. She said she wanted to attack the body, attack the legs, and then when we start seeing the later minutes of the second round and into the third round, look for Janet Todd to start wrapping that shin around the neck of Wong as she starts to go headhunting.
Nice. And his legs going into overdrive in this round, particularly the left leg. She's bringing it up high. She's taking it to the legs as well. There's another one up around the chin area, using her right leg this time. Under attack, but she comes forward as she has done this entire contest. There's just no backing off from this one.
She's definitely trying to make it a contest. You can see her throwing out those push kicks, but there's not anything disguised in those push kicks. She's just kind of flailing her legs out and Todd's just parrying him away, moving, sidestepping, and then throwing those hands in the leg kick.
Good hand from Janet Todd. One is just about getting her gloves in the way when those kicks come up to the head. But her punches don't have anything like the crispness or the heaviness, certainly not the heaviness that Todd's doing. There's another example of how she just gets that glove in the way of the kick. Good thing too, because you don't want to get kicked in the head by Janet Todd.
But you can see that's why she's starting to, you know, raise the height of her kicks. She's starting to go after that head. You can see that left hand is slowly starting to drop to protect her body. Maybe she might even start reaching for some of these leg kicks, because they're going to start to pay dividends later in the match. It just kind of builds up that equity, money in the bank that she can, you know, slow down long later.
Beautiful hook to and one's gone down, and the referee will take a good look at that. She's very game to get back up. For a moment there, I thought she'd probably had enough, but she's back up, and everything we've seen about Wang Qinlong tells us that she's game enough to go as far as she possibly can. There's just no backing down on this woman.
Todd droppers, leg kicks, hook, leg kick, hook, leg kick. Dropped Wong. Oh, and she starts wrapping it around the head, goes shin to chin.
Right.
Janet was good enough to stop there. She saw that her opponent was in some trouble. And I wonder if we're looking at the final moments of this contest. Is there enough time?
Wong's got a move.
For Janet to do the business. She's got less than 10 seconds. She'll have to really go some now. Is Wong going to survive and get a minute's respite?
Wong's got a move. And she
three knockdowns. And it's over, Mitch. There must have been less than a couple of seconds left.
Andre Yava, who in 2011 beat former UFC champion Joanna Jerdecic for a world title in Muay Thai. An aggressive start here from both these athletes. Immediately to the clinch for Janet Todd, throws the knees. Todd 2-1 in one super series, 28-9 overall, 7 knockouts. Three-time world champion Andre Yava. High kick from Janet Todd, trying to loop the shin around the back of the neck. Andriyava, who in 2010 was presented as the best female boxer by the King of Thailand at the King's Cup. An attraction that is the spectacle of world Muay Thai. Usually they get an audience of over 100,000 watching the King's Cup, so you know what a big deal it was for the presentation by the King of Thailand as the best female at the entire competition. Good counter there from Andriyava.
Janet Todd says he has to be very careful with the erratic movement of Vandriyava, who's constantly switching stances and also with a variety of spinning attacks. So expect Janet Todd to do a lot of push kicks and also start attacking with legs.
Janet wearing the traditional Prajet armbands around both biceps here. Very superstitious martial art Muay Thai, dates back some 3,000 years. Usually those Prajet armbands are blessed by Buddhist monks. Initially, they were made of pieces of cloth that were torn off a mother's clothing and wrapped around the biceps of her son when he was sent off to war. To know that his mother's love was always with him. Jab two there from Janet Todd. Made her debut in Muay Thai back in July 2009, Janet. Second round TKO of Victoria Beltran in California. Andriyava going for the high left knee. Good leg kick there from Janet. Spinning back kick. Need to drop it a little lower there, Andriyava, and maybe target the liver to the stomach and right side of the body of Janet. Overhand right from Andriyava. Round kick from Janet Todd.
I'd like to see Todd go back to that leg kick. You can see when she lands it, Andriyava's having a little bit of a stumble. She doesn't really wear it too well.
This is Muay Thai in 4-ounce gloves, folks. There is no room for margin here. Slightest error, you'll get clipped with these gloves. And down you go. Todd edges forward. Switch roundhouse kick off the lead leg. Goes high without a switch there, does Janet. Very active combatant, Janet Todd. Competed 14 times in 1 year. Back in 2017, it was a record for any American Muay Thai athlete.
Go!
And here she is in her fourth One Super Series contest.
Stop.
Janet Todd confident showing in the first round. Jab, jab, right hook there from Vandryava, then the left roundhouse kick across the midsection.
Nice little four-punch combination there thrown by Vandryava as she steps in, lands a body kick to end it. You can see Janet Todd very dominant inside that clinch. When she gets that entrenched, she locks up her hands, and she's able to have her way with Vandryava. Even though Vandryava has about a 10-centimeter height advantage on Janet Todd has a very tight clinch, and she's able to control and manipulate Vandryava. But it's in those exchanges. Vandryava is having some success when she flurries in and then finishes with the kick.
Ready for the second round of three. Who will push ahead in this intriguing contest? The circle door closes. No. Second round of three on the one fantasy game. The fans leaning in the direction of Janet Todd by 59% for the win tonight over Ekaterina Vandryeva. This one scored on a 10-point must system. So the winner of the round gets 10 points. The less dominant boxer gets 9 points. And your score, folks, wherever you're watching live in over 140 countries around the world, from TNT in the USA to Skynet in Myanmar, Toggle in Singapore, Star Sports Select in India, all over the world. For one century, the largest martial arts show ever. It's not just boring with that lead hand to set the right hand or the right roundhouse kick. It's the right roundhouse kick to the lead leg of Vandryeva. Vandryeva skipped forward, didn't commit, however. Looks for the inside leg, it takes one to the outside leg, around that sciatic nerve there does Janet. Vandryeva, a graduate of Belarusian State University, a degree in tourism management. Go! To use it, though, in the last 6 years. Applying her trained as a professional Muay Thai combatant around the world at the very highest level. IFMA 2009 gold medalist, 2010 WKN world champion.
Beautiful combination there thrown by Janet. You can see a little bit of damage on the left side of her ear there. I think she got clipped by Vandryeva. She was throwing that serious exchange.
Nice knee on the inside of the left leg here from Janet Todd. They tango, center of the circle. Referee Onari breaks them. K1 fans may recognize referee Onari from back in the illustrious K1 days. He was a mainstay on what was then the biggest kickboxing stage in the world. Now, of course, it is one super series. And we are seeing a very high-level Muay Thai contest at the moment. Hook to leg kicks there from Vandryeva.
Time just to be looks a little bit tighter in her technique. She's able to land shots right up the middle, just like that. Beautiful jab to a body shot.
There's a very interesting technique that. Oh, hey, it's smack bang from Janet Todd. Vandryeva laid out in the circle. Rafael Nari puts the count on. And the Dano rain. Janet Todd knocks out Ekaterina Vandryeva in the second round in Tokyo.
This is Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.